Welcome to this video tutorial on calculating IV drip rates. When you have an order for an IV infusion, it is the nurse's responsibility to make sure the fluid will infuse at the prescribed rate. IV fluids may be infused by gravity using a manual roller clamp or dial-a-flow, or infused using an infusion pump. Regardless of the method, it is important to know how to calculate the correct IV flow rate. When calculating the flow rate, determine which IV tubing you will be using, micro drip or macro drip, so that you can use the proper drop factor in your calculations. The drop factor is the number of drops in 1 milliliter of solution and is printed on the IV tubing package. Macro drip and micro drip refers to the diameter of the needle where the drop enters the drip chamber. Macro drip tubing delivers 10 to 20 drops per milliliter and is used to infuse large volumes or to infuse fluids quickly. Micro drip tubing delivers 60 drops per milliliter and is used for small or very precise amounts of fluid, as with neonates or pediatric patients. If you simply need to figure out the milliliters per hour to infuse, take the total volume in milliliters divided by the total time in hours to equal the milliliters per hour. For example, if you have 1,000 milliliters normal saline to infuse over 8 hours, take 1,000 divided by 8 to equal 125 milliliters per hour. To calculate the drops per minute, the drop factor is needed. The formula for calculating the IV flow rate, or drip rate, is total volume in milliliters divided by time in minutes multiplied by the drop factor in drops per mil, which equals the IV flow rate in drops per minute. Let's try an example. The provider has ordered 1,000 milliliters lactated ringers to infuse over 8 hours. You have a macro drip tubing with a drop factor of 15 drops per mil. Calculate how many drops per minute to set the IV flow rate. Using the formula, 1,000 milliliters divided by 8 times 60, since we have 8 hours times 60 minutes per hour, then multiply by 15 drops per minute to equal 31.2, rounded to 31 drops per minute. Here's a tip. When the IV tubing is micro drip, or 60 drops per mil, the drops per minute will be the same as the mils per hour. For example, you have 500 mils to infuse over 12 hours with a micro drip set. The total volume, 500 mils, divided by the total time in hours, 12, equals 41.6, rounded to 42 mils per hour. The drops per minute would be calculated as total volume divided by time in minutes multiplied by the drop factor of 60 drops per minute, which also equals 41.6, rounded to 42 drops per minute. Let's look at an example of an IV piggyback medication. ANSEF 1 gram in 100 mL normal saline to be infused over 30 minutes. You have a macro drip tubing with a drop factor of 10 drops per milliliter. Calculate how many drops per minute to set as the IV flow rate. Use the formula with 100 milliliters divided by 30 minutes multiplied by 10 drops per minute, which equals 33.3, rounded to 33 drops per minute. If you need to set this up on an IV infusion pump, use the formula volume in mils divided by the time in minutes, multiplied by 60 minutes over 1 hour. This equals the IV flow rate in milliliters per hour. Using this formula, 100 milliliters divided by 30 minutes times 60 minutes in 1 hour equals 199.9. rounded to 200 milliliters per hour. Once the infusion has started, monitor closely to be sure it is infusing at the correct rate and check the patient's IV site for signs of infiltration or inflammation. Thank you for watching this video about calculating IV drip rates, and be sure to check out our other videos.